Welcome to The Science of Clock Change, a video series by Save Standard Time to explain how clock time affects our lives. This series was made possible with generous funding from the American Academy of Sleep Medicine Foundation. Hello, I'm Dr. Karin Johnson, a professor of neurology and a sleep medicine specialist. In this video, we will discuss the history of time zones, standard time, and daylight saving time. In most of the United States, we are familiar with the convention of changing our clocks twice a year. We spring forward to daylight saving time and fall back to standard time. Some local and national legislators are moving to eliminate that twice yearly time change. But which time convention should be adopted? Permanent standard time or permanent daylight saving time? Before the modern era, clocks were set according to the sun, which meant that clocks were typically set about 4 minutes later for every 1 degree of east-west longitude, or approximately 70 miles in the United States. This difference in time became a problem with the growing railroad industry, which needed to know when trains were coming and going to keep on schedule and prevent accidents. Therefore, in 1884, the United States created its first time zones, Eastern, Central, Mountain, Pacific, otherwise known as railroad time. Ideally, the sun would be directly overhead at noon in the center of each time zone, and the sun would be at its maximum height between 11:30 a.m. and 12:30 p.m. everywhere within a time zone. However, in the United States, most borders were adjusted for socioeconomic reasons so that the western edges of the U.S. time zones have the sun overhead closer to 1 p.m. on standard time. During World War I, the United States first adopted seasonal daylight savings time, also known as wartime, in an effort both to save energy and to extend the workday by an hour. It was largely unpopular and quickly ended, but it was brought back year-round during World War II from 1942 to 1945. That was also unpopular and ended with a return to peacetime. But retailers and golfers enjoyed extra time in the evening during daylight saving time, so they lobbied to bring it back. By the 1960s, different states and even different cities within the states observed daylight saving time on different dates or not at all. It got to be quite confusing, most notably for business and transportation. So in 1966, to end the chaos, Congress passed the Uniform Time Act, which says every state can choose permanent standard time or seasonal daylight savings time on certain federally approved dates. Most agreed to follow the newly unified schedule of clock change. Some states, like Indiana and Michigan, initially opted out, but eventually joined their neighbors in seasonal daylight saving time. Others, specifically Arizona, Hawaii, and 5 U.S. territories, have all kept permanent standard time as law ever since. The United States tried permanent daylight saving time before. To find out what happened, I'm going to ask JP, the president of Save Standard Time, a nonprofit advocating for permanent standard time. Jay, can you tell us what happened?
Well, yes, in the early 1970s, the U.S. was facing the oil crisis, and it was proposed that we would go to permanent daylight saving time in an effort to save energy. There was strong support for this within the United States population at first. 79% of adults were in support of retrying permanent daylight saving time. Congress rushed to pass the law, and in 1974, it took effect. But just a few months later, support dropped quickly to only 42%, and seasonal DST was restored. Since 1974, Congress has twice extended the duration of daylight saving time, taking it from 6 months to 7 months in 1986 and to 8 months in 2005. And this is why our mornings are so dark in March and October, because we are observing daylight saving time at the wrong time of the year.
So Jay, that's really interesting that the support was for permanent daylight saving time, but quickly dropped off. Can you tell us why you think that happened?
When daylight saving time was first proposed, it was intended only for the summer months when the sun is already rising earlier. But when we extend daylight saving time into the winter, or if we make it permanent year round, then we are forcing ourselves to get up and go to school or work before the sun rises in the dark. And that it turns out, it's depressing and it's dangerous. It affects our performance in school, our performance in the workplace, our ability to respond and react and handle stress and simply be happy.
So people just don't like dark mornings.
No. I think if you're to ask most Americans, would they willingly set their alarm clocks an hour early in the winter and get up and go to school or work in the dark, drive on those icy roads and be sleepy all the way, they would probably say no. But in reality, that's what permanent daylight time would be forcing most Americans to do.
Thanks, Jay, for that little history lesson.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Currently, in 2022, 75% of Americans, again, want to end clock change. But according to recent surveys, about half prefer to end it with permanent daylight saving time and half prefer permanent standard time. The Senate passed a bill in March 2022 called the Sunshine Protection Act that would require most states to adopt permanent daylight saving time, but is yet to pass Congress and is facing increasing opposition from the medical and scientific community. To conclude, most people are in favor of ending clock change, but history shows us that permanent daylight saving time quickly becomes unpopular. Per the Uniform Time Act, any state can adopt permanent standard time. However, adopting permanent daylight saving time would require an act of Congress. Some believe states should be allowed to decide. However, as history shows, coordinated time zones are important for transportation and economy, and having a mix of policies causes confusion and increases costs, which is why a national approach is preferred. To learn more about how to harness the full power of the sun after watching this video series, visit SaveStandardTime.com. Advocate by texting SST to 50409 to tell your legislators to end clock change now with permanent standard time.